think I featured this before, but I still want to show it off because I like playing with it. It's a suspicious package, and inside is an equally suspicious package, if not more suspicious. But in this one, is nothing. It's not very interesting. What is interesting is these two boxes. This is the box that held this box, and now somehow, it is now the box inside the box that was inside the box. Welcome to the video. So, bit of an experiment going on. We spent, he spent about 3 hours yesterday putting together this contraption here, which you guys are looking at right now. This is actually an acoustic levitator. Now, what that is, no one knows. No, I'm just kidding. It's, I don't know. It's actually little speakers basically that play sound at a certain frequency that when those frequencies touch, they create a small force and you can suspend items in thin air without magnets, very light items. So we've got, you wanna grab some of that foam that we had? I don't know why I'm showing you this. This isn't a science channel, but this is the closest thing to actual magic that I've ever seen. Normally levitating things, people assume two things, and usually they're right half the time. They assume strings, which is usually probably most likely the case, and two, they assume
magnets.
They assume magnets, yeah, and sure you can make things float with magnets, however to freely like move something is very, very, that's not how magnets work. But this is never an option, so I thought this was cool. This might be the future of, you know, magic technology in the making. Maybe one day we're gonna make this big enough to levitate someone. Are we connected? What's this for?
I think so. Looks cool. It's new, you know?
All right, so now, Antoine also had to go to the pharmacy and buy a single syringe. How much did this cost?
50 cents.
But yeah, he just bought a single syringe. I thought that was a funny thing to buy. I didn't know you can purchase that. So we've got some blue and red liquid that we're going to suspend as well. We'll start by showing you this thing. Antoine, you wanna do the honors?
Not sure.
Ooh, there we go. You see that? So this piece of foam, this is just like packing foam, super light. And as you can see, completely freestanding. Run my finger under it. If I cover it completely, it'll probably fall. So that's kind of cool. We've failed yet to put water on this. I wonder if I just drop it here with my finger. So we've failed yet to put water on this. That was the whole reason I bought this kit. By the way, this literally took 3 hours to make. He had to weld this little copper wire all around. He had to put these circuits together. It's pretty insane that this even works, but I would never be able to put this kit together. You know, I've got patience for puzzles, just not for things that have any importance. Okay, so I think we should do this up. Okay, this is it. Okay, that's the point of... Am I in the middle?
Yeah. Oh.
That is a single floating drop of red liquid. Let's get the blue liquid in there. At least I'm lined up now, you know? Oh my god, and there's even a tiny one between them. It's separating. It's breaking apart. Oh, it fell into the other one. Yo, that is bananas. That is bananas. What? Yo, all right, get the macro. Hope you enjoyed this little science experiment. Here's a question for the comments. What would you use that levitation for? Would you use it in some home technology or would you use it in a magic trick? So we're gonna be checking out Reddit once again. It's been a little while, past 15,000 members. Let's just get into it right here. The subreddit, by the way, check it out, link below. Three different back palms. You won't see the last one coming. This is Bao. Oh, nice back palm, Bao. The professional. Ooh, the Asians. Oh, what? That was insane. I want to see that last change one more time. Yo, that was crazy. Here's my problem when I do the back palm. Getting ready for it. 1, 2, 3. Oh, I did it backwards. Upvote this, please. An invention of mine. One deck turns into two, then a third deck. Oh, I already know what's gonna happen then, don't I? Music or no? No music. Oh. Oh. That's quite satisfying. I actually like this very much. Let's see this one more time. Whoop, whoop. Oh my god. Huh. I want to do that immediately. Very well done. Are you that magic guy? That's his name. Well, are you? Take 68. Thoughts? I mean, I was expecting something crazier, not gonna lie, for 68 takes. Don't wanna be a jerk, but you could've at least took 69 takes. Fooling my coworker with the sloppiest misdirection you've ever seen. That was the sloppiest misdirection I've ever seen. But well done nonetheless. I appreciate that you kept that in and uploaded that. That's what it's all about. When the spectator tells you it's his card, even if it's not, don't do that. Don't give me help. Penn and Teller make an appearance in Borderlands 3. Pain and Terror. That's a great name. That's a great stage name for, like, if they did a Halloween thing. They probably know about this, but if they don't, someone should definitely tweet it at them. I think that's amazing. When I try a first time flash paper. That's great. Tic-tac magic, an invention of mine. This guy again. That's actually really dope. Whoa. Dude, that's great. Who is this guy? Somebody sign this man. He's kind of good. That is great. I hope they tip this guy. That it, wow, I did not expect that at all. I expect, you know, you watch some of these videos, some of these homeless guys are performing magic, and it's usually the cigarette and t-shirt, or like there's some thumb tip action going on, but this guy takes it to a whole other level. This guy's actually a performer when you think about it. He probably does this 30, 40 times a day. You know, he may not be selling out shows, but this act right here, this routine that he does is very good. And he's got a whole persona that he just amplified that, you know, it is probably who he is times three. And he's putting himself out there performing, probably gonna get some tip. Good on him, man. I think, you know, that's some great, I've never seen the sugar packet through window like that. I mean, I did not expect that. So pleasantly surprised. Unusual cloth, no gimmicks. Unusual cloth. Oh, I see, that cloth. Oh, that's so cool. Some Leonard Green stuff, I believe. Here we go, yeah. It's nice that he uses it with a cloth. Oh, gives him some nice cover. Not sure why you have the blanket half on your leg and half on, like, what's going on with this whole, I don't know, just half your room is covered in a blanket, but other than that, I think it's cool. First V4. No, this would be the V3 Kleenex box, okay? First Dot Shop, coming soon. The Portal, Chris Wheel. Stop with the music, Chris. I like Chris Wheel, he's a funny guy. Good magician too. Ace of Hearts goes in the pocket. Four Spades. That's a cool idea. That's a really great idea. I love this. That's great. You know what I would have added to that? I love the idea of him reaching his hand into the nether, like it's kind of disappearing. I think that's great. What I would have added to that is, as you're doing this, someone's behind you and you just see your pants pocket go like this. Like, how cool would that have been to simultaneously set that up with someone just on the ground? Like, you forget the trick. Obviously people know something's up with the cards or camera or whatnot. Just make it, I think, a little bit more magical if you had just like, your pants just started doing this, like you had like someone's hand and like actually have some, I know what I'm saying. Good job, Chris. I am a beginner in cardistry. I'll tell you what, man, you're well on your way to doing some crazy cardistry stuff. If you're a beginner and that's what you're posting, I think that's pretty darn good. My first video here. Cigarette. Nice. That's a good vanish. I love this production. Yeah. You know what kind of hurt you there? Was actually not the technique. Technique was great, and it wasn't the camera angle either. It was actually the amount of light. So because you probably filmed this with your phone, your camera is going to ramp up the shutter speed, right, to darken it. And because the shutter speed was ramped up, you saw some extra frames in there of the cigarette coming back. That little shutter speed in a normal lighting with like a lower shutter speed with a normal lighting would have probably saved you a little bit of that flash. So these are just things that I've learned filming myself, that sometimes in real life that would have worked just fine for someone, or in other lighting circumstances. So those are just things you gotta be aware of sometimes. And the fact that you were backlit too, your camera was capturing all that light. So maybe just, maybe you should have filmed this way. That way the light's hitting something and it probably wouldn't have been as bright, so you wouldn't have had that flash. But other than that, great technique. The vanish is great, the production was great, good job. A build change I created, I wanted to be able to change with no cover and not being held. Don't we all? That's like me shopping for clothes with my mom. Just want to change with no cover and without being held. I think I accomplished that. Let's see. Dollar bill. Ooh, that's really nice. That's very cool. I love the fact that the wind made it change. That's a great touch. Anytime you can have something magical happen and you're not attached to it, I think that's a win for sure. This bag is filled with a pocket of air, but still coin penetrates the walls of the sealed sandwich bag. The pitch is weak, my guy. I'm not gonna lie. Pretty sure you could have summed that up quicker. Coin through plastic bag would have been great. The bag is filled with a pocket of air, but still the coin penetrates the walls of the sealed sandwich bag. The sandwich bag is sealed, filled with air. Yet the coin penetrates the seal sandwich bag. I'm just teasing. Oh, it's the same guy. Are you that magic guy? This guy's gonna fool me again. Look at him.
And a sandwich bag. I got a bunch of these. I use them for my cash outs, my deposits.
I was waiting for the justification of having sandwich bags with you. I think it's pretty funny. Cause like anytime a magician brings in a random object, I'm always like, what's he gonna say? Like, cause you know, sometimes it's a great thing. You're like, oh, I'm gonna use my phone case. You don't even have to explain that. It's a phone case, it goes in your phone. But a sandwich bag, That's a tough one to get away with. How do we get around that? It's from a cash deposits. Trying to flex on them with the sandwich bags.
Uni and a sandwich bag. I got a bunch of these. I use them for my my cash outs, my deposits.
I'm sorry. Dude, I love your magic, by the way. I think you're great. I just think that's very funny. These are the things that I enjoy as a magician on the inside. You're wondering, how does a magician still feel joy when watching magic? That's how, right? Screw the method. No, methods are great too. But this stuff, the justification stuff.
Ever since I was younger, I've been fascinated with coffee mugs. So I have a collection of coffee mugs.
You know what I mean?
I've always had a keen passion for post-it notes. I thought we'd try something with post-it notes today.
I don't know. Okay, let's watch this video. I'm getting carried away.
Check this out, though.
Oh, he says, check this out, though. Because he says, though, because he feels guilty about the justification. He's like, oh, sandwich bags for deposits. But check this out, though. Does that make sense to only me? I don't know.
If we fill this up with some air.
There's an easier way to do that. There you go.
Nice big pocket of air. Check this out. Take the loonie, just toss it right into the bag.
Yo! That's great! That's so good. Dude, this guy is really good. I like this guy. This guy's great ideas. I don't know if he works in a magic shop. He looks like he's working on a counter where he's got, you know, one of those magic shop half moon playing card mats. This guy says, man, I love the idea, but the bag was losing air the whole time. It was kind of noticeable. And he says, only because it's a cheap, not Ziploc brand bag. Listen, guy, if you use Ziploc bags for your cash deposits, you need to upgrade the storage on that. You know what I mean? Can't be using non-Ziploc brands, you know, for where you put your cash. I think it's great anyways. You know, people are gonna say, rah, you flashed at 13 seconds. Rah, guy zipped a bag. It's Ziploc. Just be like, hey man, great job. Hey dude, love your ideas. How about that? Some positivity on Reddit. What the hell is that? So my guess, he's gonna solve this. Okay, I did not see that coming at all. All right, let's go see someone here. One last one. It is my first post, organic magic. Zero upvotes. Oh, that's clever. I see what you're doing there. Like I draw something, he's like, yeah. That's right. You can examine it. Take that gum out of the packet. I don't care. Have a look. I'll even eat it. Actually, good effort. Good on you for posting. And this place is not only for trolls. If you want to troll, all of, you know, Reddit is fine. But if people are posting stuff, be nice to them. They're learning. Obviously, if they flash, let them know, maybe help them out, or don't let them, I don't know, just don't be a dick. So ladies and gentlemen, that is it for checking out Reddit. This was one of the funnest Reddit experiences that I've had so far. If you feel the same way, hit the like button. If you don't, let me know by hitting the like button. We'll see you guys on the next video. Peace.